went to the dollar store, Dollar Tree, yesterday, y'all. I have so many projects. I ran out of folders. So I've got these little, just they're folios that just have two slots on either side. There's nothing, but it's $1.25 for three. So I got a couple of those. And then I also got a couple of, like, you know, tab folders. And because a couple of my projects are, like, much bigger, I got these little flexible notebooks. And I got a little thing to put them all in. Because I now have more stuff going on than I have place to do it. So I can actually see these things. So I spent, like, $12 at the Dollar Tree. But, you know, it helps me to stay organized. I have to see the projects. It's not good enough just to have them on my calendar and on my desk calendar and on my to-do list. I also have to have them separated because otherwise I'm not going to find anything. So let's talk about switching gears. Today was supposed to be a day where I was going to have all the day to myself and I was, you know, going to clean my house and worry about my pages later. And then my husband said, oh yeah, I'm going to be around on Saturday after around 1 o'clock, so let's do something. Well, that changed my entire world. We talk about this all the time, right? We talk about being flexible, about, oh my gosh, you know, the attorney needs this job tomorrow. How am I going to get this done? Can I get this done? What if I offer them, you know, I'm already on the book for tomorrow and I don't have my team. They weren't ready for this. How about the day after? Being able to, in your head, know what's going on. Your calendaring will help, looking at it before you go out on an assignment. Being able to pivot, having a good conversation or communication lines with your team, also helpful. Knowing what's going on in your world and what you can juggle and what you can't. And again, saying no is okay. I think I told you, right? My day up in Virginia, where they went from 8:30 in the morning until, you know, 5:30, and I had to drive 5 hours to my Tuesday assignment, and they wanted that rough draft, and I said, no, it's impossible. Can't do it. Just can't. I'm going to be on the road for 5 hours. I won't even get to where I'm going until 11 o'clock at night, and I'm on the record tomorrow. No. 370 pages? No rough draft. Nope. Not doing it. You have to know what you can and can't do. Even if I had tried to send it off to a scopist, which I don't use a scopist that often, that it would have taken a miracle for my scopist to have been available or even to have been able to try to get even a couple hundred pages rough scoped in the amount of time that, you know, I would have needed to get back to him. So I was aware of what I could and couldn't do. On the other hand, client said to me the other day, hey, do you want to do this rough draft? Well, I was supposed to be doing the job I'm doing now so I could deliver it to her yesterday. And I said, yes, but I'm going to have to push this back. And she's like, fine, because I don't want to touch this rough draft. And of course, in my world, once I'm starting scoping, it's not a rough draft. I am scoping because I'm not going to go back and do it twice. So knowing what I had, time available, what I had planned to do, I was able to pivot. So now, instead of waiting to do these, I think I've got about 80 pages left to go. Instead of waiting to do them later this evening and getting my house clean, which is never a fun thing for me, I have decided I'm going to sit down and I don't know if I'm going to get all 80 pages done by the time he gets back. I've got 2.5 hours. It's possible, but it's an interpreted depot, so who knows. And then I could go have wine on my wine passport because I still am woefully behind. And so anyway, pivot, y'all. Be able to be fully aware of what your commitments are so that you can make smart decisions when someone asks you for something that wasn't originally scheduled. They think we're miracle workers, and it's great that we can often make it such that it happens. But sometimes, you know, we're human beings, and sometimes it just is not doable. And there's a picture I have. It was a sticker and it just says, I'm not in your hurry. And this is one of the things I teach at the law schools. I say, look, you know, if you know you're going to need that transcript, let the court reporter know when you book it and when you get there. Say, I think this might need to be expedited. So if you need to make any emails or contact anybody before we get started, let them know. So I think, you know, it's fair to ask these questions, and it's fair for us to say, you know, I'm sorry, if If I had known, I would have been able to get my team available, but at this point, I just don't think that it's doable. It's not unreasonable, and, you know, I mean, it's always nice to be able to accommodate people's requests, but it's not guaranteed, and you're allowed to have an evening. You know, I saw somebody posting the other day about, oh my gosh, I just got an email from someone who wants a rough draft of the transcript, and it was like at 6:30 at night, and I literally posted, I'm like, why can't we just have business hours? Say, I only answer emails from 8 in the morning until 6 p.m., and at 6 o'clock at night, you turn on that response to your email that says, you know, I am not in the office at the moment. Your email will be addressed next business day. I mean, why do we have to be available 24/7? I mean, it's nice, but I mean, we're all entitled to sleep and to have family time. And I think regaining that sense of equilibrium is important. And to remind people that you say I'm the most important person in the room, but you kind of forget that, don't you? Anyway, I'm going to get these transcript pages out because I want to have some fun later. I'm just switching things around. That means I have to clean tomorrow morning instead. Have a great weekend, y'all.